Hey, this is Nurgle from Behemoth. How are you, fuckers? You're watching Metal Injection. Stay metal. Cheers.
Rob here with Nurgle from Behemoth. Nurgle, always a pleasure. You guys just completed recording a new album.
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yes, sure. It's called The Apostasy. It's done. It took us forever to complete it. Obviously, I was close to, you know, to go insane in the end of the session. We spent like 4 months in the studio, 3 months tracking it down, and then 3 weeks in Sweden doing the mixing and mastering. So it was lots of time, but I think it was really worth, you know. It was like very demanding record, you know. So we pretty much have to, yeah, I mean, that's what we had to do, you know what I mean?
Right.
Just to beat Demigod, because Demigods, you know, turned out to be like a big success for the band. I mean, relatively big, but, you know, pretty big. And we just wanted to, you know, to overcome ourselves, you know. So we did everything we could to do the record that'd be, you know, artistically. I don't know how it's gonna, you know, I mean, how people's gonna are gonna receive it, you know. But for us, you know, being artists, you know, from artists, prospect, you know, we wanted to beat ourselves, you know, we wanted to overcome ourselves, and I think we managed really. And well, we got a new record. It's like 11 songs. It's it's very diverse album. We got lots of guests there. It's very organic too. It has very thick sound. It sounds bigger than Demigod.
Well, you said you have guests.
Who's appearing? We got real choirs there. We got trumpets. We know no samples, no bullshit. You know, it's yeah, man. It's and the drums are like all of it is like acoustic. You know. And we got Leszek Mozdziak, who's like a worldwide famous pianist, doing one song called Inner Sanctum. And the same song, we got Worrell Dane from Nevermore singing on that song, so it's really cool, yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a huge fan of Nevermore, a huge fan of his voice, you know, so I was really, really happy, you know, when I get to know that the guy was like totally into doing this, you know. So, yeah, I mean, there's lots of things happening, and I love it. But it's still like too early to judge, you know. Let's talk in, you know, this summer.
And I'll get back to you when I hear it, and I'll let you know what I think. Okay. But speaking of the summer, you guys are going to be on Ozzfest,
yes,
which is free. Good news for us, not so much for you, because I hear you're not getting paid. What's up with that?
I think that the fact that we are on it, and the fact that we're going to play in front of thousands of people every night is... it's enough payoff, you know what I mean?
Right.
It's not always about money. It's not always to, you know, getting your share, you know. It's sometimes something more, you know. This is the highlight of our career, you know. Not just a career, probably life, you know what I mean?
Right.
And let's see what happens, you know. It might be like, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's going to be a blast. The whole tour, you know, it's an honor. I know that people who book the second stage are my fans, you know.
Yeah.
And I met these guys, you know, like a year or 2 years ago, you know, when they get to the show and they bought our shirts and stuff, you know, like, what the fuck, you know? I was really surprised, you know. And then when they started talking about having us on Ozzfest, you know, but I never ever imagined that we'd end up having like a fixed slot and a direct support to Hatebreed. It's crazy, I love it. I still don't believe it, you know, so until I'm not there, standing on stage and playing the songs, you know, I'm not gonna believe that.
Right.
So
you guys are definitely, you know, probably the most brutal band on there. Are you gonna show Ozzy what it's like to be grim by, like, you know, biting the head off some 7-year-old child?
I don't think that anyone can really prove anything to Ozzy. You know, and I mean, it's like, hey, come on, you know, just this is history. This is fucking legend. You know, just be grateful for the fact you can play there, you know what I mean? Yes, we, along probably with Nile, we are the most extreme band there. And I'm happy that the promoters, Sharon, whoever is in charge for that, you know, they decided to bring some dangerous music to the table.
Yeah, definitely.
And I think it's gonna just, you know, spice it up a little bit, not just fucking, yeah, you know, radio-friendly music.
You're gonna scare the shit out of Middle America.
I really hope so. I really hope so, you know. And to be honest, you know, we're unleashing the new record around that time. If you've seen the pictures from the new session, we got like lots of crazy shit going on, and like new masks, you know, and armors and shit, you know. We're bringing it all here, you know. It's gonna be the biggest production in the US for us so far, you know. We're already talking about it with our manager, and we wanna do like a big production, as long as they let us. It's gonna be crazy, you know. It's gonna be bigger than anything we've done in the US before. So Yeah, it's not gonna be like, okay, let's do like mid-tempo songs, you know, so people can catch up, you know. Fuck that. We're gonna start with a blasting song, we're gonna end with a blasting song, you know.
Some blasting songs in the middle.
Yeah, in the middle, yeah. Which means, yeah, like all the like 30, 40 minutes is gonna be pretty much just...
Parents, lock your children. Behemoth is coming to a town near you. Check them out on Metal Injection.